Welcome back to Bolt Action CP for another battle report. Tonight we're doing the mission Demolition. 1250 points. My Germans versus Andre's British. So in this mission we each have a base on our side of the board and we have to make contact with the enemy base to destroy it. So that's the objective. My mic is not working right, so I have to just use the phone mic, sadly. So I got my new phone, and my old mic doesn't work with it. But anyway, that's the board, city board. So he's got his objective over there by that blown up building. And my objective is right by the fuel tank there. So we'll take a look at the horses.
Did you catch that?
Yeah. Okay, here's the Germans. So I have four squads of six guys, LMG and SMG, two Panzerfaust. Got a lieutenant with an extra man, assault rifles, they're all veterans. They also have an eight-man assault pioneer squad with a flamethrower and SMGs. Two Panzerfaust. I have a medium mortar with spotter, a Panzerschreck, and a Kubelwagen. I got three trucks with medium machine guns and a Wirbelwind. So, and then these guys over here are just extra guys that I'm going to use to replace anyone who fires a Panzerfaust with a non-Panzerfaust guy. So all my infantry is veteran and all the rest are regular. Okay, I'm gonna start with my vehicles. Two half tracks with MMGs. The truck is an LRD armored truck, which means it's got three MMGs on it. The Bren carrier with the LMG, and the tank is a proxy of an A9 cruiser Mark 1 CS. What that means is it's got a lot of MMGs on it. So it's actually got two side arc MMGs and a coax on the front. For my troops, all of the red hats and these end guys over here are all paratroopers. So I've got 3 5-man squads of paratroopers with submachine guns. I've got my commando squad with submachine guns and one group of veteran infantry with rifles. I've got a sniper, which we're showing off today, freshly painted. Thank you, Travis. And I've got my free observer and my lieutenant, a mortar team, and a flamethrower team. That's the Brits. All right, so that's the forces. Now we'll go ahead and deploy and be back. All right, so we're done deploying. This mission, we had the alternate deployment rule where you put everyone who's deploying, you put their die in a bag and you alternate just like pulling dice out during the game, but instead of moving, you deploy. So I decided to leave two squads, a truck, the Panzerschreck, and the Kubelwagen in reserve. Andre brought everything in. So we'll start off over here. I got my medium mortar, and I forgot to deploy my spotter. So I'm going to real quickly just put my spotter in this building here. So medium mortar, spotter's there. I got my eight-man engineer squad, so my objective's there. Then moving this way, I got the gray truck has two squads, or it has a six-man and the officer. The yellow truck has a six-man, and then the Wirbelwind is there. So Andre's got his gun truck. Inside the ruins, flamethrower team and a six-man veteran squad. Heavy mortar, no spotter. His officer in the ruin there. half track with 2 5 man paratroopers. Got his World War One tank there. Bren carrier with 5 paratroopers, and then over there is another half track, and that's got the 10 commandos in it. So that'll do it for deployment. So go ahead and do turn one and be back at the end of turn one. All right, turn one is now over. A lot of moving, everyone kind of moving up in this turn. Start off over here, my flak veerling moved up into that crater and fired at his gun truck that was there, and we found out it was a recce vehicle, so he recce'd out. And then my machine gun fired at the mortar and missed. His mortar fired at my gray truck that had a squad and the officer in it and missed. But then they did take a pin from the half track there that drove up. So his half track drove up, and with the 50 cal, even the 7, he put a pin on the truck. And the truck tried to move and failed his order, which pretty much screwed me over because I was going to drive up and occupy that ruin there. Instead, the officer and the 6-man squad had to run just to get to there. The one of the 5-man paratrooper squads that was inside the half track got out and took a shot at the squad and missed. The other one is in there, just went down. His Bren carrier drove up and with the LMG put a pin on and killed one of my 6-man squad there, a rifleman. And then the 5 guys inside there got out. Over here, he double timed it with his half track full of commandos, so they couldn't do anything but run up. My engineers went down. I mean, they went on ambush on the very end of the turn, so they'll probably stay in ambush. My mortar fired at his mortar and missed. His sniper in that building there fired and missed my mortar, luckily for me. Of course, probably won't be like that next turn. Needs a 4 to hit, so he might get another round of shooting. And over here, he has a flamethrower, went down. The squad inside, the veteran squad, fired and put a pin on my whirlwind. His machine guns from his World War One tank put a pin, so he's got 2 pins. This truck drove up and fired on the mortar and missed. And then these guys drove up, got out of that truck and killed one of the paratroopers. And that's it. And that smoke there is the free observer strike. So that'll do it for turn one. We'll get started on turn two. All right, welcome back. Turn two is over. As you can see, the middle, I've lost all my infantry in the middle. That artillery strike came in and just wreaked havoc. It dished out pins everywhere, and then he got 2 6s with the 4-inch template for the heavy howitzer, so he wiped out my 6-man, or my 5-man I had left, my officer. They died. He even hit the truck, but he only rolled the 1, so he just put some pins on it. He had a bunch of pins, he rallied and lost them all. My flak, or my whirlwind, was kind of waiting to the end to rally. And he did rally. He took a couple more pins before he rallied, and he only lost 3 total. So he still has 3 pins on him. I had another squad kind of in the ruins. They moved up, fired 2 Panzerfausts at that tank. Actually hit it both times, or hit it once and rolled a 1 on the pin, so he just stunned him. He went down to the 2 pins. So they were standing there, and then the 3 paratroopers, I didn't know there was 3 of them, I thought there was only 2 of them left. The 3 paratroopers moved up and hosed them down with the SMGs, killed 3 of them, and they failed their morale check. So that's it for my push onto the British objective. So we'll move over to this side where the British are coming in. So I decided to pretty much just defend my objective. That's my whole goal now, to play for a draw, pretty much. So I had my engineers, you can see them there, out there now. The half track drove up, fired on them with all their machine guns, just killed one guy, put a pin, and they came around the corner and unloaded. They killed both Panzerfaust, killed the half track, and they flamed the five-man squad and submachine gun them. They got down to one, but there's still one left. He's got two pins. That half track just moved up. I don't even know. He shot at the truck, my truck over there, and putting a pin on him. And the squad inside, there's still a five-man in there, went down. So after I blew up the half track, all his commandos got out. But my squad on the other side of the wall there, I ran them up earlier before that happened. And then this squad I just brought up. So you got a 10-man commando squad, one guy, and then five more guys inside there. And I got what's left of that, and a 2 6-man. And my mortar just fired and missed on his mortar. His mortar fired again on this truck and missed. So this side is pretty much dead. I think my Wirblewind is going to be pinned out for the rest of the game. Even with rallying, he's still going to just collect at least 3 pins per turn. So that'll do it. The artillery strike pretty much screwed me over in the middle here, and then failing my morale check. So I have no infantry left there. So that's it for turn 2. We'll go on to turn 3. Alright, welcome back. Turn 3 is now over. And looks like things have taken a big turn for the Germans on this side, where the massive assault was happening. And pretty much status quo over here. That will start over here. My Flak Wehrling rallied early. He had 3 pins. I was able to get rid of them all. I think part of my problem last turn was I waited till I had too many pins. I needed too big of a D6 roll to get rid of him. So he's got 2 pins on him. So he's going to be have a good chance of getting out of there, hopefully. Yellow truck just rallied, but he got another pin. My gray truck finally did something, drove over, fired on Andre's gun truck, and put a pin on him. That was it. He passed his order, and he put another pin on my Flak Wehrling and the truck. And his lieutenant moved up, fired, and missed. His tank failed his order. His five-man squad in that building put the other pin on my Flak Wehrling, and his flamethrower is still in there on ambush. These guys here advanced through the building, through the ruins, to there, and then I brought my third truck with a machine gun, put a pin on them. So over here is where all the action was happening. So he had, well, first of all, that Bren carrier was killed by my Panzerschreck team there on the left, came in and blew it up. So he had a 10-man commando squad there, and he pulled the first die, and my engineer squad was there. He pulled the first die and failed the order to gun him down with all the submachine guns. And then I got the next die and came over with the flamethrower and lit him up with that and all of my SMGs. But the flamethrower is the thing that did all the damage. Killed 5 of them. D3 plus 1 pins, and they failed, so they ran off. And then since then, that squad has been whittled down to 3 guys by a combination of the half track, that squad with them, some machine guns. Each of these, they even took fire from the Bren before it was killed. So they're down to 2 guys. They got 3 pins, but the flamethrower is still in there with fuel. And his sniper has taken 2 shots at him and missed. So he's got a 5-man squad of paratroopers and a half track and 1 paratrooper there. So I got 2 6-man squads. I put both on ambush because he's hidden behind the wall right now. So we'll see what happens there. And my mortar took out his mortar finally. He got a hit on the third try and wiped him out. And I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. So we'll go ahead and do turn four and be back at the end of turn four. Alright, turn four is now over. Over here we'll start off my black virling right away. Tried to move the hell out of there because it only had two pins. But he failed his order and he reversed back and went down. So, and he's taken another pin from the gun truck since then. So he's back up to three pins. His officer came out, took out my empty truck. My other truck here just backed up and fired on his officer and missed. His tank failed the order again. And the 5-man squad decided to come out. Sensing it's safe, they came out. His squad that was over there ran up to there. Over here, he loaded his single paratrooper into the half track, drove around, killed my other truck, and he's there. Over here, I'm still on ambush. I decided not to take a shot at his half track. These guys, I don't even remember what those.
They whiffed.
Oh, that's right.
I shot
they,
your.
They totally shot. Over. They shot at this squad and completely whiffed with all their submachine guns.
Needing fours,
because they went down.
10-3 or less.
That's right. They went down, so they needed fours at point blank, and still couldn't hit. So, his sniper did take out my mortar crew, and that's about it for turn four. The only real action left is he needs to get to that objective. But I got two squads with two Panzerfaust each and a Panzerschreck. My Panzerschreck fired at his half track and missed as well. So that's it for turn four. We'll go ahead and be back at the end of turn five. Yeah, here we are again. Turn five is over. This is what it looks like now. We'll start over here. My flak virling failed in order and reversed again. And my truck here fired on his gun truck. He actually penetrated it, but only stunned it. His squad's moving up slowly. His flamethrower is still in the building. And his tank has failed again, the order. His officer ran up. So these three guys jumped the fence and fired into my 6-man squad there and actually killed two of them, including one of my Panzerfaust. And then his 5-man squad that was there came around the corner and I unloaded all of my both ambushes on them and killed all of them. And he drove around and somehow took out my Panzerschreck in a miraculous heavy machine gun shot. He killed the assistant gunner and forced a morale check that the Panzerschreck failed, so he's out. So he could, Andre could have won the game by running that one dude out, because he would have the last die, but he decided against it, so. He went from sure victory to maybe a draw. We'll see though. That's about it for turn five. So we'll go and do turn six and come back and wrap it up. All right, turn six is over and Andre's won the game with that one guy there. So he drove his half track up,
and parked it right there. And I, well, I had a partial squad still in the crater, but he assaulted with his three paratroopers, and I lost the combat by one, so they ran off. And over here, I did kill his half-track with my Panzerfaust, but, and it didn't kill the guy. If I would have killed him with the explosion, he wouldn't be there, obviously, but I didn't. So he was able to get out and go down right there by it. My Werbelwind finally actually got to do some, but he needed sevens and missed. He tried to shoot the guy off the objective. His officer just ran up. His gun truck passed his order with one pin, immobilized my truck. His World War I vet driving the World War I tank is failed another order. I think it's a record.
That was
every order, wasn't every it? Order in the game from turn two on. That squad just moved up, so I had no pressure at all on his objective. So pretty much I lost the whole middle of the all my forces in the middle from that artillery strike and failing the morale check. And then my open top flak Veerling just kept getting pinned and pinned, and I'd rally and I'd get pinned and pinned, and I finally was able to make it out of there, but he was no effect on the game. Basically, it all came down to this side. I had my engineers and 2 6-man squads hiding inside here to defend the objective. They did pretty good, considering all the vehicles and units that were coming for them. So I lost half my army and still almost was able to pull off a tie. So I think for me, my obviously my MVP is my engineer squad, even though they failed their order the past two turns. But they did wipe out a the half track with the Panzerfaust, and they killed the commando squad. And well, that one guy is the one guy that was left when they flamethrowered that. So I've been having a real issue with one guy, veteran paratroopers lately. One or two of them is almost worse than a whole squad of them, because you can't hit them, can't kill them, they don't die. So anyway, who's your MVP, Andre?
Well, not to try and piss you off, but it's got to be the artillery observer.
Oh yeah.
That was the key to, as soon as that happened, it freed up all my excess forces. Not that I necessarily was able to move much over, but that eliminated all pressure off of my objective and let me completely focus on just what's it going to take to break in over here. And the paratroopers in a half track, I'm impressed. You know, it's quite a few points, but it's a lot of firepower, a lot of mobility, and it's just, you know, as Travis was saying, it's tough to deal with them.
It is. They're really tough, those paratroopers. They're stubborn and everything. So, yeah, that damn free observer, I've always hated that guy. I think as many times as we played, I think maybe twice, I've seen you roll a one. And one of those times was last game when the rule changed in random direction, so it just flew off into nowhere. Actually, that was my observer that did that. So that, yeah, the observer is really a pain in my ass. He did a number on my force in the middle, that's for sure. So anyway, that's it for this one. Andre pulled it out at the end, although I was able to make it close.
Unfortunately, this is only one win in a row for me.
That's true. I have won two in a row. I recorded both, but because of my mic on my phone issues, I wasn't able to post them. Or I did, but they sound like crap, so hopefully this isn't as bad with no mic. But anyway, thanks for watching this one. We'll be back next time for another one.